Hi everyone, it is Kato. I joined a YouTube swap and my partner was Mozekyto. Draculaura is one of my favorite base dolls, so I used her at this project too. I already removed her factory faceup and I finished the reroute. I'm using pastels to repaint her mouth. I'm drawing green eyes for her. To do this, I'm using my Derwent watercolor pencils. Second layer of paint. I'm drawing over the existing lines and I'm using darker shades to intensify the first layer. I like to use black on the eyes, but I'm still using dark gray. My time to draw everything well. I'm using dark gray, but later I will draw over it with black. I'm using pastel to create the shape of the eyebrows, which I fill with watercolor pencils. Third layer of paint. I'm painting over the existing colors again. I'm using watercolor pencils to intensify the lines of the eyebrows. To give an intensive blush for my dolls. I'm also adding white pastel as a highlight. With a thin brush, I am intensifying the color of the lips and the eyeshadow. finally, it's time to add black to the eyes. I am using these fabrics to make the dress. I want to make a mermaid dress. I am using a silky fabric and lace to make the top part. I pinned the fabrics together to fix them in place, and I will use my sewing machine to sew the parts together. Of a needle. It is taking for a while, as you can see. I am using zigzag stitches at the bottom part of the dress, then I am sewing this part to the top part. I am using paper under the fabrics to avoid the sticking material. Here I'm sewing the lowest part of the skirt to the rest. Travel with this wooden chest, which is good for putting clothes into it on a long journey. I want to achieve a vintage style, so first I'm using white paint to paint the chest. I am adding a cracking varnish. I am using this Hungarian brand called Pentart. After the varnish has dried, I am painting over it with brown paint. Sandpaper to sand down the edges of the chest to keep the final look of it. And this is the finished wooden chest. Do you like it? The last step is to write a letter to Mozekyto and wrap the doll. But before I wrap her, let's see how she is looking like. Here here she is with the finished hair, face up and clothes. To reroute her, I used the golden rose saran hair and I decorated her hair with feathers and beads. I decorated her dress too with a piece of lace and beads. She has painted nails and blushed hands. My doll which I created for Mozekyto. Thank you for watching, see you next time, bye!